Hello guys, it's Darksigner here from the German Duel Masters channel and welcome back to another video. Today I got the match for 3rd place from IDC 11 for you guys, where we have a modest duelist at the top of your screen on fire, nature, water or rock control, however you want to call those three colors, and Solomon at the bottom of your screen with fire, nature, rush. And let's see who takes 3rd place in IDC 11. Solomon not with the greatest start here. I believe he bricked on multiple Gontas because, yeah, charging Gonta turn 1 is not what you ideally want to do. And Modest answers with an Gonta of his own. Let's see, I think it would be better to get out two creatures on board rather than one speed attacker now, because you need to get stuff going fast before a searing wave can hit you. But yeah, that's also a fine play, getting rid of the opposing Gonta and then playing one other creature and going in. Solomon thought it was a surfer, as Modest really took a long time getting that card into his hand. Maybe it was a soul swap and that would not have been that useful. I mean, I probably would have used it if I was him and it was a soul swap to get out the Hearty Captain, because Hearty Captain basically removes itself after one attack. So yeah, kind of easier to deal with. And now Solomon has the speed attacker. And yeah, correct to attack with it last, because if he hits into a surfer, he would have needed to bounce the speed attacker and next turn you can just play it again. So it's definitely looking like Solomon has this game. Modest can't really do too much on 4 mana. Can kill the speed attacker, but if Solomon has another one, it's probably game over. I think the best you can do is charge one and play Bronze Arm Tribe and a 2-drop. That way you get more stuff on board and then, like, maybe somehow getting to Twin Cannon in the turn after that. Of course you need to survive next turn, so hoping that Solomon doesn't have another speed attacker in hand or that his last shield is a trigger. But without Bronze Arm Tribe there's no way that he can get Twin Cannon out next turn. But of course, yeah, he can hope for a surfer and shields, and that way he gets enough attackers on board. I think it needs to be surfer now. Yeah, that's nothing, so looking kind of rough, because he can't play double Magnus and Searing Wave doesn't clear the board. Nothing Modest can really do here. I mean, if he has Surfer in hand and double Soul Swap, he could do something against the board, but even then, yeah, that's definitely not enough. So he scoops it up and Solomon takes game one. Kind of rough in Modest position, as Solomon didn't have the greatest start, but couldn't capitalize on it. But yeah, from my experience, it's really hard to win against Fire Nature Rush. You need Surfer and Shields, otherwise you just lose. I played the same deck for IDC 11. And yeah, we had so many Rush decks in this tournament. Kind of hard to win without Shield triggers in that matchup, as you can't control the matchup in any other way. You don't have discard, and your field removal is also quite limited in Searing Wave and yeah, Hardcast Surfer. So definitely rough if the triggers don't work in your favor. Because basically both decks try to do the same thing, only that Fire Nature Rush is faster, and yeah, Fire Nature Water can play the game a little bit longer. It's not over in turn 6 or 7 against control. You still have more options to win the game. But in the head-to-head matchup, Fire Nature Rush is definitely favored, as it's just a little bit quicker. Solomon, with the Quixotic here, 2-drop and 1-drop, so that's quite fine here. Sets up for game next turn, unless Modest has a Searing Wave here. Modest really thinking hard. I think that indicates he doesn't have Searing Wave. Otherwise, I think that would be the easiest choice to get rid of the Quixotic and Hardy Captain Polygon here. And he needs to build his own board. That's not looking good. I think, yeah, if you have a Pyrofighter here, you could start counterattacking into shields and just hope you have Surfer and shields and survive. Otherwise, I don't see what you can do to win this game. You just have to start attacking against Rush, and yeah, that's exactly what he's going to do. Just counterattack and hope your shields save you the day. So I definitely agree with this move here, because that sets up game next turn for Modest if he manages to get Surfer out of the shields. But yeah, luck needs to be on his side. If I was Solomon, I would still go for game if I have a speed attacker. I'm not worrying about the Bronze Arm Tribe. I think you have to take the chance here, because otherwise you might still die to Surfer if Modest has double Pyrofighter in hand. And Sniper plus Speed Attacker, yeah. I think I would go for a game here if I was Solomon, but he doesn't. He tries to play it safe. Now, yeah, Modest can win next turn if he has a Surfer and shields. That's basically what it comes down to. If there are no triggers though, I think the game is definitely over, as he can't deal with the board and hand at the same time. Solomon thinking about stopping to attack, or which attacker he uses first, because yeah, I wouldn't stop here just because of the fear of Surfer. You should still go for it. And that was nothing. It looked like it, as it lagged for a second here, but no trigger. Yeah, and with no triggers, I think that's definitely game over. Solomon takes this match quickly, 2-0. So, yeah, nothing Modest can really do here. I hope you guys enjoyed this match. Modest just waiting on the right time to scoop the game up, but that's definitely game over. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and with that, see you guys at the next one.